phone in your hand or your tablet. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Welcome again to the campus family. It's a joy, a group, a blessing. I'm glad to have you. Keep on teaching on. I'm glad to have my group too. Good old faithful. Thank you for every one of you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. He alone is worthy. Mr. Mandela was talking, he went to the book of Hebrews, you know. The only problem, I don't like coffee, so he does the brewing, not me, so he brews. Thank you, Jesus. I went to Apple, I was trying to get a discount on my iPad. They won't give me any discount. Because when I turned the Apple on, it looked like somebody beat some of it. He was in the Apple sign before.
Yeah.
It looked like it's beating somebody beat some of it. So I said, hey, I want a discount. It's not a full Apple. You like my joke? This is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
My Bible,
my Bible
is the word of God.
I agree
with God.
I am
more than conqueror. I'm above only.
I'm
not beneath.
I'm
the head.
I'm
not the tail.
I'm not the tail.
I can do
all things
through Christ
that
strengthens
me.
I agree with God.
Jesus.
Look at this again. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. By the word of the Lord, a couple of people came here this morning, discouraged. God has sent me to you to share with you before I preach. And that is this. Don't you ever give up, no matter what you're going through.
Yes.
If what you're going through is overwhelming to you, remember one thing. You have the God factor.
Yes.
If God be for us, who can be against us? If that did not spare only begotten Son, but having delivered for us all, I shall not freely to give us all things.
Yes.
So if there's anything in your life today that is discouraging, the only thing I got to tell you is the good news. God is with you.
Amen.
You talk to God and you have it worked out.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. He said, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock. When you pass through waters, have it with you. To the fire, you shall not be burned. To the river, it shall not overflow you. I am the Lord thy God. It's the glory and the lift of our head. It's the author and the finisher of our faith. You are not alone. Inside of you is the Christ of God. For the mystery of the gospel is Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm ready to preach that. Amen. You came in a good day. Some people gave me a discount. It's 00 to get a discount. 00 discount. Walking in God's ministry. Rule number one, God is holy. Without holiness, no man shall see God. If you want to walk in God's ministry, you must walk in the ministry of holiness. God loves us. God cares about us. Do not make an excuse for not working with God for you. Being a Christian is not something you put on Sunday morning. It's a way of life. Hallelujah. You did not choose me. I chose you that you go forth and bear fruit, that the fruit shall remain. It's not enough to go to church. You have to allow the church to go through you. Hallelujah. The preaching of the gospel does not come with the enticing wisdom of man, but in the demonstration of the Holy Spirit and of power, that your faith should not rest in the wisdom of man, but in the power of God. We've had enough of just going to church and going home. No! You need to come in to the Holy of the Holies.
Yes.
Do not stay in the outer court.
Yes.
The outer court is for the Gentiles. Come on into the Holy of the Holies. You belong to God. You are more than conqueror. You are above only and above. You are the head and the tail. You can do all things. True God that strengthens you. It's the glory and the lifter of our head. It's the author and the finisher of our faith. You can make it today.
Yes.
Because Christ living you. You have a hope in every situation.
Yes.
Don't you ever give up. When things get tough, look unto Jesus and he see you through.
Amen.
I know what I'm talking about. In my senior year at Southern Illinois University at Edwardsville, one of my degrees was in a double E, electrical engineering. In my senior year, there was a particular course that is so difficult. No matter what I did, I tried to study it. I stayed up. I had an exam coming in the morning. I stayed up. I tried to study. It just will not come together. Anybody ever been there, you try to study and it's not coming together? Okay, welcome, you came in the right place. Hallelujah. I went to sleep. In my dream, the Holy Spirit began to work the problem for me. He said, son, you understand it? I said, no, not yet, Lord. And I work it again and again. He said, if you see this formula, this is what you use. If you see this formula, this is what you use. He said, you understand? I said, no, sir. He kept on working it. Until I understood it. When I woke up in the morning, I was ready to go.
Amen.
I show up in class. First question, what the Holy Spirit worked out in the middle of the night? Second question, what the Holy Spirit worked out in the middle of the night? Third, what the Holy Spirit worked out in the middle of the night?
Yeah. Wow, wow, wow. Yeah. Glory to
people
God.
Were cussing and swearing because they were made. I was singing the Zion song, thank you, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I was about to take a class one time, a particular test, exam, advanced medical thing. I was sitting down studying about an hour before the test. I pick up physics. Holy Spirit said, no, put it down. He said, let me show you this, because we're going to see it again. When he said to me, let me show you this, he gave me a vision of anatomy, the pelvic area, the kidney, and different things. It's like, wow, this is it. So I went to open the pages, to put up what I saw with what God was showing me, what he was showing me with the page. When I opened the first page, guess what happened? All in there. I'm telling you this, study hard, and then pray, and let God lead you by Spirit. Yeah. You have an advocate, it's called the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
You can do all things through Christ that strengthens you.
Yeah.
And don't you ever give up, don't you ever quit. The problem is this, the pleasure of sin is for a season.
Yes,
and if you're not careful, you subscribe to just a little leaven, it can leaven the whole door, mess up the door. Just a little sin. Just a little secret sin.
Yeah, yeah.
And without holiness, no man shall see God. Be ye holy as I am holy. You have to make up your mind. No compromise. Say, Lord, you keep me. I want to be kept. The Bible says God is able to keep that which is committed to him. If you commit yourself to the Lord, he'll keep you. He'll give you a vision of what's about to happen. He said, would I ever do anything without talking to my friend? You are my friend if you do what I command you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. The Lord was about to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah. He said, would I ever do anything without talking to Abraham, my friend? And Abraham said, well, since I'm only a man, you are a righteous God. Will you destroy the whole place? If 50 people are righteous in there, God said, no, I won't. He said, well, since I can talk to you, I can agree, and I'm only a man, nothing but a debt. What if it's only 40? Lord, don't get upset with me. What if it's only 30? You see, when you have access to the throne of grace, you live in the realms where all things are possible. Don't you ever forget that. Many people depend on the physical realm, and then you give up on everything else. So that's where the prayer comes in. You have an access to the throne of grace. Whatever you ask in my name, I'll do it for you. Hallelujah. Say, go to the Father in my name. Hallelujah. And whatever you ask, I'll do it for you. He meant it. It's not a cliche. It's a reality of life. He loves you. I like Romans 8:32. He that did not spare his only begotten Son, but have him deliver up for us all. How shall he not freely through him give us all things? Jesus says, if I can die for you, I can surely help you in every situation. So don't you ever give up.
Amen.
In order for you to give up, you have to forget the God factor. That you're a Christian. How can you be a Christian and forget that Christ lives in you? Definition of a Christian, by grace only, through faith only, and in Christ only are you saved. If you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, and you shall believe in your heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead, you shall be saved. For with the heart, man believe unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. As the scripture says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Yeah.
What does it mean to be saved? You have an access now. Abba, Father, you can call him Daddy. Hallelujah. He shall come to pass before you call, I will answer. While you are yet speaking, I will hear. I belong to you and you belong to me. With men, sometimes time, possible, but not with God. And since you have God in your life, all things are possible for you. Don't you ever give up. Don't you ever quit. Don't you ever give up. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. He alone is worthy. Working in God's ministry. Rule number one, God is love. If I give everything I have to the poor and I do not love, I'm nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not puffed up. So there are people that do you wrong that you have to forgive. Not because you're wrong, but because you choose to obey God. The Bible says love covers the multitude of sins. I can never tell you how many people have done me wrong and if I get mad with them and discard them, then I just finish using a fish.
Yeah.
See, you are, how can I put it? A bridge. You walk through a bridge to get where you're going. Be willing to take an insult for the sake of winning somebody to Christ.
Hey,
hallelujah. Be a bridge. Let them walk over you and get where they're going.
Hallelujah.
They're coming to Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. He alone is walking in God's ministry. God's ministry is the ministry of reconciliation. It's to bring people back to God. Hallelujah. Ephesians chapter 4, let's take a look at it. Starting from verse 11. Ephesians chapter 4. Thank you, Jesus. He alone is worthy. 11 through 16. So Christ himself gave the apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers to equip or for the perfection of the saint, to equip his people for the work of service, so that the body of Christ may be built up until we all reach the unity of the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God and become mature. Become mature. God said, I don't want you to be a baby Christian. Children can have asked for a car, but you give children toy cars, they go under the fridge. But as a mature person, God said, I'm going to give you the real, something I can take you to work. Hallelujah, not something that goes under the fridge. See, when I was a child, I had like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. But as I grow in the things of God, I put away my toys, I put away childish things. Hallelujah, I put away childish things. Hallelujah. God said, I'm serious. If you want to walk with me, I'll walk with you for real. Some people are satisfied. Be an ankle deep Christian. God bless you. Get to heaven, maybe you watch the restroom, they have one. But you need some stars on the shoulder. Come on. You need to shine a star. This is a crooked and a perverse generation. Make up your mind. I belong to God. My body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Without holiness, no man shall see God. You're a new creation, not a demo. Don't let anybody test drive on you. No test driving in the kingdom. You belong to God. Hallelujah. God saved me, and after he saved me, he kept me. He kept me celibate for 10 years. I'm not ashamed to tell you that I was kept by God. God will keep you if you want to be kept. When it's time for me to be married, he says, son, I'm going to send you to Nigeria to meet your wife. Hallelujah. Population of Nigeria, 144 million people. And God sent me to Nigeria and met my wife within 24 hours. And we got married 8 days after we met. I've been married for almost 25 years with 4 children and in the honeymoon stage. Because God did it. It's the right and the left shoe. See, if you do it yourself, you're going to have 2 left shoes and one fit. And you get 10 books on how to fix a corn remover. Because you did it by yourself. See, it's not the way it looks, it's the way God said it is.
Yeah.
You have to see through the eyes of God.
Yeah.
God put Adam to sleep,
yeah.
And he came up with Eve. So where was Adam when God was looking at Eve asleep? So you have to go through God to get the spouse that God has ordained for you.
Amen. Amen.
You pray and God will lead you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. As many as are led by the Spirit of God, they need the sons of God.
Yeah.
You cannot go by what you feel. Oh, she look cute. Oh, you look handsome. You got through missing God. The part you see is not the part you're marrying. It's a spirit inside of it.
Yeah.
I'm a spirit.
Yes,
I have a soul and I live in the body. So don't you ever get deceived. Oh, he. It's not going to always look like that. You got to go through God to get there.
Preach, Pastor.
I don't want a marriage that will last a month or a few years. No, I want permanent.
Yes.
Permanent.
Hallelujah.
Let me tell you something that will make you interesting. Something interesting. Before I met my wife, I would go preaching in places, and somebody would say, oh, God, I think God is saying you're going to be my husband. I said, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. Next week, I'm going to preach as evangelist. You come with me. Usually what happens when I finish preaching within 24 hours, I'm going to have a fight. No, you're not the one, the back is not covered. When I met my wife, I was in there preaching, nothing came back. I preached again, nothing came back. Yeah, thank you, man. You got my back.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hallelujah. Everything you desire in this life, God put the desire in there. If you delight yourself in the Lord, I'll fulfill the desires of your heart. God said, what I have in store for you, you don't have the slightest idea of it. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has it entered the heart of man. The thing that God has in store for them that love him. It's like, I got something that will knock your socks off. You don't have the slightest idea of who you are or what God is going to do through you. God said, I'm going to use you to save lives. I want to use you to bring soul to the kingdom. I want to use you as an instrument in my hand to transform lives. For you are living epistle, bread of all men. You have to be careful how you walk or how you live. Because people are looking at you. The single most reason why people do not come to Jesus is not because the gospel is not being preached. It's because it's people that talk the talk but refuse to walk the walk.
Hallelujah. That's the truth.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. 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 I'm going somewhere. Hang on with me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Build up the body of Christ to the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God and become mature, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. That then we will no longer be infant. Then we will no longer be infant, tossed to and fro by every teaching. Tossed to and fro by waves and blown here and there by every word of teaching and by cunning and craftiness of people in their deceitful scheming. There are people that want to deceive you, so you need to get yourself familiar with the Word of God.
Hallelujah.
Get yourself familiar. Let there be a daily thing that you read. Hallelujah. Have a one-year Bible, you know, a little bit of Old Testament, New Testament, Psalms, and Proverbs. If you read a little bit, like in a day, about 15 minutes, in a year, you will have read the whole Bible through. So when somebody is talking to you, if it doesn't line up with the Word of God, inside of you will be the Holy Spirit that says, it just gives you a scripture that contradicts what they are telling you. So you don't get deceived.
Yeah.
Whatever the Word of God is, that's what discernment is. Hallelujah. You need discernment so you don't get tricked. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are in school. You need discernment to find out what teacher is supposed to take. You cannot take every instructor. You have to be led by the Spirit.
Yeah.
It can make a difference between an A and a D plus.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
And as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they need the sons of God.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. He alone is worthy.
Yeah.
Glory be to God in the highest. On earth, peace be unto all men. On whom his favor rests. So walking in God's ministry, God said, I'll save you. The purpose for which I save you is that I can use you to save other people. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians chapter 5. Amen. He alone is worthy, worthy to be praised. You are so precious today. God loves you today. God cares about you today. God is saying, once I save you, I want to use you to save other people. So Jesus is for the world. The Holy Spirit is for the church. So you take the baton back to the world. Give it to them. Come to church. Get filled with the Holy Spirit. Take it back to the world. You constantly have to take it back to them. You have some friends now. You eat with them all the time. You fellowship, and you know they are not saved. If they ever die and they go to hell, they're going to say, wait a minute, you hypocrite, you had to do it for 10 years, never told me about Jesus. Sometimes you have to be willing to risk your friendship for the soul of a person. I don't want you to just like me and then you go to hell. I don't want to hurt your feelings. So I would rather not tell you that because I don't want to. Wait a minute, if they reject you after you tell them about Jesus, God bless you. When you stand before God, you cannot point a finger at my face. That I didn't tell you the truth. Speaking the truth in love, that's what grow to be like him. Stop compromising. Don't be like a chameleon, just changing colors. Stay in one place. Stay on those sides. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Yeah, Lord is worthy. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians chapter 5. Amen. Verse 10. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, and so each of us may receive what is due for the things done while in the body, whether good or bad. So have that in mind. Whatever I do now, I'm going to appear before the judgment seat of Christ. Not for salvation, but to say, what did you do with the time I gave you? Our life is like a jar. You turn it around like this, hourglass. When the last drop drops, you cannot extend it. That's it. So whatever time you have left, let us make up our mind. We're not going to compromise our work. We're going to stand for Christ. You shine as stars in the midst of a crooked and a perverse generation. You belong to, I can reveal what I have in store for your life. Hallelujah. Don't just go around, just not knowing your purpose. A life without a purpose is an experiment. An experiment is something you do in the lab. If it doesn't turn out, you throw it in the trash. Because no, you are not an experiment. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are unique. Hallelujah. Uniqueness in Christ for you. Hallelujah. Because draw nigh to me and I draw nigh to you. Wash your hands. Purify your heart with open-minded. Come to me and I will. Hallelujah. Come unto me and I will answer you. And I will show you what are mighty things that you do not know. I am the one that forgives you of all your sins and your iniquities. Your sins and your iniquities will I remember no more. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Some of you are still walking in condemnation. You forgot that Christ forgive us of all our sins. 1 John chapter 1 verse 9. If you confess our sins, God is faithful to forgive us of all our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Hallelujah. You don't clean the speech before you catch it. Come the way you are and God someone to transform your life just the way you are. Hallelujah. Don't get religious. Oh, I come to God after I get my life together. You will never get your life together. You cannot clean yourself. You need the blood of Jesus Christ to cleanse us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He alone is worthy. Worthy to be praised. Verse 17. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Thank you, Jesus. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, it's a new creation. New creation has come. The old has gone, the new is here. Sometimes some of the friends that we have, we know they meant no good. You know they're gonna cause you to stumble in your walk with God. It's either you bring them in or they take you out.
Yeah, yeah. Right.
So make up your mind. I'm staying in. Mm-hmm. I'm staying in.
Yeah.
We used to like to party. Every Saturday we make it happen. We contribute $50 a piece. They said, and have a party going on. They said, what are you doing? We don't know, but there's a party. Let's go. All of a sudden, I gave my life to Jesus. I got saved. And I pick up this list. I went down the list of the folk. Hey, something happened to me. They said, what's that? I said, I gave my life to Jesus. They said, oh. They said, maybe we get together next week. That was more than 30 years ago. We're still getting together next week. Some of the people you have in your life that don't want to go with God, you have to let them go.
Yeah.
Share with them this gospel. If they reject it, they don't want to do it, God bless you. I really love you. Whatever is not in line with what God wants to do in your life, you have to be willing to let go of it, no matter how dear it is to you.
Yes.
Before I met my wife, I met a lady. Everybody that saw that, they said, oh, she's a gorgeous. You better hurry up and marry her before somebody marry her. Well, I got saved, and I talked to her, I said, hey, you know something? I give my life to Jesus. She said to me, I will not touch you with a 12-foot pole. I'm not ready for that yet. Oh, praise the Lord. Have a nice day. God bless you. The willingness to let go of the forbidding for the sake of Christ is a mark of a true Christian. The willingness to let go of the forbidding for the sake of Christ is a mark of a true Christian. Stand up on your feet, that's my wife in the back. She's cute. Cuter than who I had before. That's what God gave me. We married almost 25 years, she still looked like 25 and a half. You know, it's impossible. I said, baby, pop her here so I can speak in tongues. Shakramata. She kills. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. If I was one of you in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone. The new is here. Old King James says, if anybody be in Christ, a new creation. All things have passed away, the old things have become new. So we have to understand that it's a new walk now. We have to understand that you have to see through the eyes of God now. You cannot see the way, you cannot go through what you see anymore. You cannot be limited to what you can see or feel or tell. Right now, you are right here. You cannot tell me what's going on in the parking lot, but God can give you a vision of what's going on in Africa or what's going on right where you're sitting.
Yeah.
If you see through the eyes of God, then you see with the mind of Christ. God said, call me, come unto me, and I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things that you do not know. You belong to God. You belong. There are people that make you mad, and they say, right not to forgive, but I give up my right when I give my life to Jesus. See, the Lord is my Savior and my Lord.
Yes.
The Lord said, forgive, so I have no choice.
Yes.
But let go for the... Let me tell you something. Sometimes we play by double standard.
Yes, sir.
If it's us, we ask for mercy. If it's somebody else, ask for justice. God said, don't do that.
Yes, sir. Wow. Hallelujah.
Lord, I need your grace. Please help. Please save me. And they say, you are...
That's so true. That's
it. Yes, sir. But I'm going somewhere.
Hallelujah.
Verse 18. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. Verse 19, that God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against them. Not counting people's sins against them. This is a recording. Not counting people's sins against them. This is a recording. Not counting people's sins against them. So there are people that sin against you, that as you try to reconcile, they come to Christ.
Yes.
You want the people
yes.
to Christ. So don't, you don't have no room for unforgiveness or bitterness, because if you do, God cannot use you for his glory. Hallelujah. The basis of the blood of Jesus is a full forgiveness. Are you listening to me?
Yes,
full forgiveness. That's the basis of the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
We are forgiven. Hallelujah. He said, I am the one that forgive you of all your sins and your iniquity. Your sins and your iniquity will I remember no more. God said, I love you. I care about you. You are somebody to me. You can make it today.
Yes.
Stop looking at your circumstances and let that determine your future. Hallelujah. I have four children. All my four children, when they were born, I was in the labor room with them. When they were born, I said, give the baby to me. I lift them up to Jesus.
Yeah.
Let me tell you a secret. When you see a baby, they look cute and pink. That's not the way they came when they came out of the bad canal. They're full of gunk. Well, they are only fluid. And they have to be wiped. See, what you're going through is not you. The beauty of Christ is inside of you. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. So don't go by what you see when the baby came out of the canal. He's been in the abnormal fruit for 9 months. So you want the baby, they look beautiful and pink. That's not the way they came. Coming out, they're full of gunk in the body. And that's the way. So whatever else is going on in your life, whatever is trying to keep you from reaching your goal for Christ, God say, I'm going to wash it with my own blood.
Yes.
I'm going to be beautiful and people that sing.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You have a hope today.
Yes.
You have a hope today.
Yes.
You never, don't ever give up. Don't ever quit.
Yes.
If you quit, then you're a loser. But God calls you more than conqueror. God doesn't miss words when he says, you are more than conqueror. He says, you are above the heaven, you are the head and the tail. You can do all the things God has strengthened you. It's the glory and the lifting of our head. It's the honor and the pleasure of our faith. God is our refuge. God is our strength. It's the very present heaven. That's of trouble. Therefore, shall we not fear? Hallelujah. Those mountains will move and we can't be the music. There is a river where we shall make glad the city of God. God is in the midst of us. He shall not be moved. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of hosts is our refuge. God said, the Lord our God is mighty in the midst of you. The Christ that we receive today, don't you ever, for that a moment doubt that Christ. Things are not the way they look, things are the way God said they are.
Yeah. Thank you,
a fisherman in the pond, or the sea, you see a worm dangling. All this says some good food. If you see through the eyes of God, you see a hook, so you know not to eat. So if you eat, that's the last time you'll have a fish fry. So devil is dangling some sins in front of you. But that's a good worm. You better leave it alone. Toasted ravioli. That's what you get toasted. Thank you, Jesus. God is not counting things that we did wrong. God said, I'm not counting. The only person that is counting is you in cooperation with the devil to bring yourself down. If you count the things that you did wrong, you are counting with the devil to bring yourself down.
Yes.
That's working in the ministry. People, you do wrong, you have to be willing to let go of all offenses. But it doesn't make anybody this. Why? Because the love of God compels me.
Yeah.
Since all of this is the love for Christ.
Yeah.
Inside of this is the love for Christ.
Yeah.
The love for Christ. The love for Christ. So for the sake of that, it's always my turn to reconcile. You know that? If you're a Christian, it's always your turn to reconcile. If somebody do you wrong, do somebody wrong, you have to go there and say, you know something, let's come together with this. Let's talk about this. As far as it depends on you, live in peace with all men. Hallelujah. As far as it depends on you. That's the ministry of Christ. Ministry of Christ is ministry of love. I just read it to you. Not counting all their sins. Things that we did wrong, he said it wasn't counting. If you count, we're going to hell. You know why? All men have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The wages of sin is death, and but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Romans 6:23. But they say, I'm not counting. Because it's not counting, leave room for all of us to come in. Because if we count, we'll fall short of the glory of God. I'm so glad they didn't come off the cross. When they said, if you claim to be the Son of God, why don't you come down now? We believe you. If you came down, we're going to hell. Don't come down. Stay up there. Thank you for dying for my sins. Don't come down.
Amen.
You know what you're talking about? If you come down, if you came down, we died for our sins.
Yeah.
They were taunting him. Somebody died for you. Sometimes we are blind to who is helping us.
Amen.
I don't know why we do that. Hallelujah. Some of the friends you have will speak the truth and love to you, and that's the one you don't like. You like the one that will help you to put put a finger in the fire. It's a blue flame. The blue flame is the hottest part. All you do is cute. You can put, no, that's not the kind of friend you want. You need somebody that will speak the truth to you in love.
Amen.
That's a true friend.
Amen.
A friend indeed is a friend indeed. You need somebody that can speak the truth to you in love in your life. And don't reject. Those are the kind of people you need. You need somebody to stroke you. Why are you going to hell? Oh, you're doing good. You're doing good. No, you shouldn't be doing this.
Right.
You need somebody to tell you the truth. Speak the truth in love. The Bible says, as you put your hope in God, as you shine as stars in the midst of a crooked and perverse generation, I will shine through you.
Yeah.
Most of the things of the gospel is just the way you live your life. The way you live your life. The cussing and swearing and cheating and lying and sliding, you didn't do any of those. People come to say, wait a minute, there's something so different about you. There's something so, I don't know, you don't do what everybody, what is it about you? Then you have to be willing to give the reason for the hope that you have. But if you live hopeless life, they won't have you nothing. Because they're hopeless and you're hopeless too, the way you live, even though you say you have Christ.
Yeah.
Be willing to give the reason for the hope. Reason for the hope. So live a hopeful life, so that people can ask you for the reason, for the hope that you have.
Hallelujah.
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 God wants me to tell you this. It's all my promises for you, for your life. They are all yes. And they are all amen. How's it going to happen? I don't know. Not that do you know. But it's not by power.
Amen.
It's not by might. You just keep on following him. And seeking for the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things shall be added unto you. I got a plan for your life. The plan I have towards you is a plan of good and not of evil. Thought of that I have towards you. To give a thought of peace, to give you an expected end. And I shall be fond of you. Come unto me, and I will answer you. And I will show you great and mighty things that you do not know. You belong to me, and I belong to you. I want to live my life through you. I want to express myself through your life. For you are living a epistle read of all men. A epistle is a letter you write to a group of people. The Bible says when they look at you, they see Christ. And living a epistle read of all men. People will look at you. People that say, oh, I don't like reading the Bible. All the girls just look at your life. They read the Bible without knowing it, for you are living the epistle. Hallelujah. God has a height for you to reach like you never imagined before in your life. I'm telling you, God has a height for you to reach. I'm sitting the president of corporations in this place, president of corporations, multinational companies. I'm telling you, I'm speaking by the Holy Ghost now. I'm speaking to millionaires. I'm speaking to people. I mean, great plans. Not just physical, but people that are connected to God. They can be rich and be godly. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
That's my prayer. I said, Lord, I don't want to ever be rich if I cannot have a personal relationship with you. I want to be rich, but godly.
Yeah.
If I can't be, if you have to lose me if I'm rich, then I don't want to be rich. I just want to stay close to you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Get your priorities straight. God said, I want to dream my dream through your life.
Yeah.
I want to dream my dream through your life. Hallelujah. You can make it today. Don't you ever quit. Don't you ever give up. Don't you ever quit. God is turning a prayer away. Hallelujah. If any man lies in heaven, ask God. And God will give to everyone that asks. He said, but when you ask, don't start doubting. Because a person that is doubtful that can wave over the sea. They will do something, but they don't follow through all the way. You ever seen a wave before, waves of the sea? They go vroom, 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 and then they pull back. Vroom, vroom. God said, I don't want to do it there. Stay with me. So I can carry you to the plan I have for your life.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I want you to give you some visions and a new dream and a new anointing. Hold on. I'm going to carry it out in your life. As I'm going to speak,
Hallelujah. I'm going to begin to give you a new anointing and a new plan. The plan I have for you before, I gave it to you, but you didn't understand this, your plan. It is so overwhelming, it kind of dropped the vision. God said, I don't want to do it there. Whatever I have for you, I'm going to, you cannot do it by yourself. I have to carry it out through you. So therefore, you have to hold on to the vision. Get a notebook and write it down. So when things get tough in your life, you can go back to the vision. Like, God, you told me this, and I'm holding on to it.
Amen.
Thank you. Don't ever settle for less. There's greatness in you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I'm not just motivation, I'm prophetic now.
Yes.
Greatness. Greatness.
Thank you.
Greatness.
Thank you.
Don't you ever quit.
Thank you.
Don't you ever give up.
Thank you.
I'm supposed to be dead at bad. I'm supposed to be dead at bad.
Yes.
I'm so glad my mother knew the Lord. While my mother was pregnant of me, prophet, two different prophets, different locations, talking to my mother, hey, the child you're carrying in your womb, it's not a regular child. You cannot go to the hospital to give back to this child. If you do, you die and the baby will die. You can only give back to this baby in the church. In the church. Somebody else will come. Somebody else. Different state, different people, different states. That prophecy. So they went and prepared a place for me in the church to be born. When my mother was in labor, they ran to the church. Hallelujah. And they have intercessors. People that have access. A saint, not the end. People that can get a prayer through. Hallelujah. I look for a watchman to see if anybody can get a prayer. I saw none. We need some intercessors. People that can pray and shake the heavens. Shake the heavens. And not change. Have a landing. Hallelujah. I'm getting there by the grace of God. I'm going to send that back. Hallelujah. For God loves something that I'm here today encouraging you. That's where I got my name from. My name is Oluwa Bori Ota. God is the conqueror of all his enemies. That's my name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bless you today. Be encouraged today. Thank you so much for your time. I appreciate you. There's greatness in you. I can see it again. I sound like a broken record. If everyone of you in this room, that's the sound of my voice. God has something special for you. Something so unique, that's why you cannot be jealous of anybody else. Because what God has in store for you, nobody can steal it. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has it entered the heart of man. This is the heart of store for them that love me. If you love me, keep my commandment. Just keep on keeping my commandment, I'll keep on revealing to you what I have in store for you. Hallelujah. Nobody can steal it. You are destined for greatness. You can make it. You can make it. Rekindle the vision. Rekindle the anointing. Say, Lord, you know something? It's you and me today. I'm not going anywhere till I hear from you clearly. Lord, create in me a clean heart. Renew the right spirit within me. Show yourself strong in my life today, Lord. Have it done to you. Oh, hallelujah. I think I'm done. I can send those people to you. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your anointing.